Well, there are two major groups of ways to monitor patients beyond the light microscope. The first is multiparameter flow cytometry, using a panel of antibodies to detect specific leukemic phenotypes. This is a tricky process because you have to be able to identify, generally at the time of diagnosis, what immunophenotypic pattern represents the AML cell that's going to kill the patient unless we get it under control. You have to identify this leukemia-specific phenotype at diagnosis and then determine if any residual cells are there with that same phenotype at the time of remission or thereafter. And so that is, at the moment, technically a bit difficult and not standardized. The second major technique is based on the mutations that are present in the leukemic cells or possibly on certain specific expression patterns that might be present, for example, WT1. You might be able to detect the level of WT1 transcripts as a way to monitor the leukemic burden that's more sensitive than morphology. But the more common subtype of this molecular monitoring is asking what mutations are present at diagnosis and then seeing if you can detect those mutations with reverse transcriptase PCR, which can be quite sensitive at the time of remission. Of course, that's dependent upon the knowing what their mutation is at the time of diagnosis, so it can be quite patient-specific.